Thank you. practice right hand, left hand.
When I practice right hand, I am this.
And you do that separately, right? So you do that probably in the morning, and then you have a break, and then I would have another break, and then go practice. I need a break now. Okay, yeah. How much warm up do you do? How much warm up do you do? Those technical exercises.
About 30 minutes.
Uh huh. Do you do scales?
Thank you.
slightly too mezzo piano or piano. You know, it was a bit less loud than possible. So this one went to hear how you're gonna play. I think you have more confidence on the guitar. I mean, this shows that the guitar, you know, the instrument that we pick is really important. And when you are trying guitars, you will know immediately what you like. You know, sometimes people ask me like, oh, what do you think, should I try it? Like, you know, you don't have to ask me. So that's a bit of advice from me to you, like in terms of guitars. So that is, thank you, that is the work with the strings and stuff like that. But I also noticed something that's very interesting, and you have a very good technique, right hand, left hand, you practice every day. I can tell, you know, except skills. You practice every day, and that's great, but I think it could be a bit more focused, if you know what I mean. So, and this is something that I had to work on as well, especially when I was in high school, which you are. why I had to do it then is because I bought the guitar and it just didn't respond to me anymore with my old technique, you know. So I had to a bit. I mean, it wasn't huge, but it was a change, you know. So the thing is with the right hand, for example, I noticed a bit of there's a lot of intention, you know. There's one point, but it doesn't come out the same always, you know. For example, you put a lot of meter. I do that as well. That's what you practice. A lot of effort, and then it comes up like this, you know, instead of. Which is bad. then just move me a little bit here, and then I was back. Because I felt like I was going to lose something, or that my tone color is not going to be as nice as before. But no, it's really going to be different. And we need that different in pieces, especially here. Because it's really long. It has many different sections. It's basically, this is a fantasia in terms of form. And it's a bit long, like it's at least a minute. So it needs a bit more variety, you know, and we need to make a strategy, you know, and place them in correct places, you know, and in order to do that, we need tools, you know, and this is one of the tools. I just wanted to point out something, not that you are doing anything wrong, but you play differently when you play faster. Why? Just a recap. When you speed up, when you play something a bit faster, that's why I wanted to play like really slow. The different combinations. When you play fast, something happens. But what? With this. But do you feel it like that? Like when you lose control? Okay. Does that happen in the left hand sometimes? Do you have the same feeling here? Or in the left hand, or is it different?
It's
a different story. Okay. Because I noticed actually your left hand is very good. You should play more skills because I think you'll be really good at them. But I also think they will help you more with your right hand. You know? I think it's something that has to do with, again, focus, but like individual focus, if that makes sense. You know? And there are a couple of amazing exercises that I use as well, you know, when I practice stuff like this. I'm just going to be honest, why I didn't want to play some pieces is because I thought that I couldn't, you know. And that's a problem when you need to play something and you don't feel like you're going to play it, you know. You don't feel like you are good enough. And that's why it's really made me stuff like this, you know, invocation and dance and pieces like that, they really made me play space. It's all a dream at this point. They made me think about practicing slightly differently, you know. And these kind of simple exercises are a part of that. I'm not gonna harass you with, you know, and everyone else with, but instead of like playing slowly, what you say. It's nothing. It can be much slower. It can be like insanely slow. I like to practice like that, not only because I'm insane, but because it really is a great way of working on something. Like really falling in love. I think you're gonna find a way. Just when we want to have a couple of simple combinations. When people ask me how much do you practice, every day. And then I tell them, you know, I practice 5 hours. And then the other time I will tell them I practice like 15 minutes or I don't practice. Sometimes I tell that the people, you know, they get upset. What? You ask a question, I answer. How? I think it is much more important. How do you practice? Without how much? And then this much needed, how much do you practice? Don't. It's a horrible question, but yeah.
About 3 hours.
Every day. Yeah. Which is, that's great. You know, that's something that kind of almost happens naturally when you're working on something. That's why when I'm, you know, practicing for concerts and stuff like that, I don't really think about those 3 hours because I know that they will happen. You know, it's simply, you know, how life works. But if I'm not careful, most of my practice can turn out to be just a bunch of and that's slightly easier, you know, especially when you're working on something that is going very well and then you're putting it through. But I think it can be a trap, you know, a problem. And that's why I have a couple of very like practical solutions, and I know some of you use them, maybe. So I do 3 very simple things, especially when I'm working on something for the first time. So number one, I just read the piece without the guitar. And I think that's a really great way of practicing. I don't know how many of you do this. Okay, that's good. And at least one, that's good. But this is a trick because when we learn something new, for example, my teacher gives me, I don't have teachers anymore, but let's pretend, capriccio. And then I'm stuck, okay? I'm playing. No. Just leave it. Leave it at that. And then just read it. Especially since you've been playing, you know, guitar and learning music for quite some time, you can do this. You don't stop. You look at it. Why is this good? Especially with like really long pieces, you kind of get the idea of what's happening and what you need to do. That's number one. And the other thing is, which is very important, you kind of immediately notice the problem parts. Like something you kind of feel is going to be difficult, you know? So instead of postponing it, you know, I'm going to do it tomorrow, the difficult part, this reading will tell you, okay, I need to start doing it now. And that's my second phase. So the first phase is just reading. The second one was with the guitar, but just going through like a jungle, through these kind of difficult places where you need to figure out fingerings. This is very good practice because it kind of forces you to focus, you know. I used to study like that as well when I used to study. Other things, except, you know, other than guitar. Just pick different parts and like really work at them. I'll show you how. And then the third one is amazing. And this is, you almost, I have to do it, force yourself to start your practice session from a different place, but every single time, you know? And I think Capriccio is a really good example of that. So instead of when you practice, starting from or even this or whatever, start from the, you know, middle of the ninth page. You know, you look good at everything.
Every day, but sometimes at the beginning, those days, and in the middle,
okay.
Or the difficult
have really on purpose, you know. And this is actually a really good exercise that will help you go to that other stage, and we'll talk about it later. I'm gonna stay here after. You have to leave after. Okay, let's stay. Because there are two more stages after this, and it's regards memory. Because memory is a tricky thing. Especially when these are really long, difficult pieces, you have a whole program or a cycle for an hour and all that. You really need to think about what you're going to do. You know? I don't want this to sound like, you know, just a bunch of weird advice. This is something that we should all kind of do more regularly. You know, when we really think about what we are doing, you know, and practice focus. Focus is really hard. For example, when you're studying other things, other subjects, how long does it take you to focus? When you are reading something, a book or whatever, when do you feel like you are actually reading it?
About 10 minutes.
About this one, you
know.
So anyway, the other day I made a mistake and I picked up a book from the library. It took me like an hour to start reading, you know, because I was a bit tired, you know. And I just couldn't focus. And then I remembered, okay, I do this all the time with the guitar. Like, how do I do this? It's practice. That's practice. You know? So when people ask, you know, how much of it, but it's how, you know, and not how much. But more practice. And now you're gonna play again. When we have 15 pages, or 12, okay, it's more than enough, you know. It can be easily like 8. It would still be long enough, you know. I would always look at, when I'm doing phase number one, reading without the guitar, which part is the most loud and intense, most dramatic? Which one? Like exactly this one. The most dramatic. Mm-hmm. Okay. That's your final answer.
No. Maybe it's this.
No, you were right, it's this. You see, you have to be, you know? You have to tell that story or not like that. But yeah, I'm right. Yes, but it's, I know, but what's also important is that it's long, you know? Would you say that this is also equally dramatic? I think I would, and you know why? Look at what he's writing. This is very important because Tedesco, when he was composing and writing stuff, like literally writing things, he wasn't writing them like, you know, when he writes an accent on every single note, that really means something, you know. So I know that you hate me, but can you play for me from this part until those accents? Going down to is, I think, what's the number one? You said this is the most dramatic part, and then you do a tsh, 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 tsh.
Oh.
You get, okay. So this is, you really need to be very secure with these chords, you know? So, another trick, when you have chords like this and stuff like that, do only the left hand. Just leave it, leave the right hand, and just practice the position, okay? So what's the first one? Left. Okay, the second one? Okay, third, and fourth. And left, yeah. So really just the left hand. Because you don't really need it. Because you know the right hand, you don't know the left hand. That's also an example of practicing, you know? And we started from a different place, you know, not always from the... and also why I told you that this is the most... More than enough. Okay. Well, not really. But... Stay. I'm going to mention some of these things in the other lesson. This one. How it should be played. So probably not here.
No.
Because it's... I know he's not at this issue. But this is just the other part. Of course, I just played should be. It's an Italian composer, after all. he could hide it. This is like really, it's a drama. This is a telenovela, basically. Yeah. Someone is pregnant and now he's gonna kill someone. It's that kind of situation. I think so, yeah. That's, you don't have to think about it like that. You know, this is just an example. But this kind of stuff helps shape the piece, you know? So how would we play this? If we decide, okay, this is the most dramatic part, this is very important. Let's try. Without the guitar, you know? Because you can actually save time. We don't have that much time in the world. You know, we will die very soon. So before we do that, we need to read the F in the capricho. It's not my fault that we're gonna die. But this is that kind of a piece, you know? It's that much drama. So that's my second. But with this, because it repeats three times, right? Personally, I wouldn't complicate things. I would play them exactly the same three times. Times five. One, two, three, four, five. And with that. Hopefully. also when I'm practicing tempo, rhythm, and stuff like that, I just pick one note. I don't play like five, six chords, stuff like that. But if I'm practicing just the tempo and the rhythm, then I just do this. Because you're not wasting that much energy. It's hard to practice like this because you are really investing a lot of energy. And it's also, you're practicing the piece, you know, without, you know, putting that much effort, you know. I think that's not a bad idea to look at it. Also, really read it. How much time do you have?
It's already over. Do you need more time?
Just one more minute. Okay. Because when I practice stuff like that, I pick the most dramatic part in terms of loudness, and then I pick the opposite. Like, what's the most dramatic, quiet part? Okay. And here, there is no, like, universal answer. There are a couple of options. But which one would you choose? That's a clear one. But you also have, if I can just show you that. That one is excellent, yes, great. But you also have a major, well, we are going from D minor to major. That's also an excellent opportunity. And it's also, it literally says maggiore. So, I don't know why, because people can read this. I think that's why it was important for him to write that this is a different part. This is something else. It's contrast, you know. And if you don't know, I'm not going to say that. For example, that. And when you put stuff like this, when you have fortissimo or forte fortissimo, when you have piano or pianissimo, then you will know what to do for the piece, you know. There's a danger that sometimes things, especially the guitar, because it's not as loud as this over here, it can sound a bit like this. So you need to make this out of this. You know, basically a piano, but you know, like very small dimensions. For that, we need contrast. But I'm going to talk about this with other people as well, so stay. Yeah. And if you need some advice later, we can go through some things. Feel free to ask it. I hope I didn't confuse anyone. I know I sound super sick as well. But this is really important, and I think a lot of people, because I used to do that when I was slightly younger, tend to skip these things because they start doing it for like, oh, just let me play already, you know. But they are really important, you know, reading, going through different places, picking the loudest part, the most quiet. These things that have a practical purpose. And that can help you.
Yeah.
nice. Except we know what it was. That's it, but I wish one. Something that he played beside me. Change them. Why? Because new strings, regardless of the guitar, you know, whatever, we have our guitar, that's it. Everything sounds a bit fuller, you know. Yeah, of course. That's why we put them. But I know, I also hate changing. It's my, you know, washing dishes and changing strings. Hate it. Okay. Study number two by Lomas, also not my absolute favorite, but just like Capriccio di Abruzzo, I had to learn it. But I think we can learn a lot from, especially from pieces that we don't want to play. And I think this was also another one. This was my mini Capriccio.
Pero cree que podemos aprender mucho de las piezas, en especial de las que no queremos tocar. Y piensa que esa es una de ellas, que para él es un mini Capriccio.
And it also, I cannot say that I learned from this piece, but I will. One very important aspect of music, and that is repetition.
Repetition.
Yeah. Repeating. Okay. That's a compositional technique.
Yeah. Podría decir que una de las cosas que aprendí de esta pieza es la repetición.
And I know that the repetition is obvious because we have every bar repeated, you know. But not only that, in terms of structure, in terms of what we do, in terms of positions, it repeats itself.
Y no solo porque gráficamente en la partitura cada compás aparece en las barras de repetición, sino que tanto también la estructura, el hecho de estar repitiendo y repitiendo.
And Lopez really did that brilliantly in these 12 studies, right? My favorite is the number five. That's a genius work. I don't think a lot of people really appreciate how amazing that piece is, but I won't go into that. If someone wondered, that's my favorite, number five. So that But I can see that I'm learning notes from that. For me, without repetitions, just the first page, until the that was also my point. How long have you been working on this piece? A couple of months. Both a year. But there were new strings when you started by practicing. She will help you. Yeah, exactly that. Let's not betray ourselves. Try one more time. But try it from the place when you started to repeat things. Do you know which one? So from the bar which you started to repeat. Which one was it? Did you know? Okay. What happened now? Do you feel like maybe a bit insecure with the left hand and the right hand? I don't really. Especially in front of me like us. We just practice together. Like I said to him as well, I know you were thinking about what from the beginning, but without it. And except the first.